just want to do a little rabbit update. We should have 3 bred does right now. Daisy down here, who had the last litter, should be due in a couple weeks. And I just bred my silver fox girls, my sisters, a day apart, Coco and Pepper. This is Coco, and Pepper's over there. Pepper's actually a day ahead of her sister, so hopefully they'll both take. This will be their first litters. My husband finally got all the little babies that were scampering around in this indoor pen. Finally got them in the freezer, all 7 of them. So we're good on rabbits for a while, and then by the time we do these 3 litters, we should be good for all winter. Because I don't like to breed in the winter, it just gets too cold, and I don't want to mess with heat lamps and all that. So, Tim 2's had a very good week. Our last 2 weeks, I should say. This is something that I picked up a couple weeks ago, actually, for the rabbits. I needed overflow cages, so if I needed to separate male and females, I could have some place to put them. I also want to get a second buck eventually, and I've got to figure out a way to enclose it. It shouldn't be too hard for winter. Right now it's facing south, so I've got to, and it's up against the barn, which takes care of the west, but I need the north and the east sides at least closed in, and probably I'll do the west side too. The cool thing about this is I have an outlet in my barn right around the corner here, right up here, okay, and so I can run an electrical line out here, and this thing that came with these hutches, this frame that the person built, is wired for electrical. There's an outlet there, and there's one down here, and then you plug it into your extension cord right here. I wish this was on the other side, but oh well. So I can run, whoops, I can run the extension cord from the barn and wire or plug this in. And then I've got 4 outlets out here, and if I don't have rabbits out here, I can use these outlets for heaters for the pig waters, which was something that was kind of bugging me. Like, how am I going to keep the water unfrozen this winter for these pigs out here? Well, with this thing out here, that hopefully will solve it. I haven't checked it out to see if it works, but if it doesn't, I'm sure my husband can get it working. But this whole thing costs $75, which I know some of you are going to go, gee! But I didn't want to try to nag my husband to build me some more cages, and it was just exactly what I was looking for, and he already has enough on his plate. But the nice thing about it is all these cages, they aren't as big as I like. I like to get the biggest cages possible, and these are like 24 by 8, no, yeah, maybe 24 by 18 or 24 by 24, but they all came with the trays underneath. So it's an intact unit. They all came with the little pellet feeders. So, you know, there's some accessories there that cost you money. And like I say, it was all intact. And this was a big thing for me because I thought, oh, I can solve 2 problems. I can have overflow cages and I can plug in pig waters or pig heater waters. Pig water heaters. NyQuil, it's a good thing. makes you a little crazy. Anyway, so that's an update on the rabbits.